Q103 hanging out backstage, Mayhemfest 2013. It's Styles, joined now by Rob Zombie, out in support of your brand new album, Venomous Rat Regeneration Vendor. We'll get to that here in just a second. But I want to talk about starting off first, man. Every time I've seen you on the road and on live, just the stage setup is always such an amazing experience, visually, with the characters, the props, and even the screens and what you display. When you're building up the tour and you're putting it all together, what's the thought process behind that for you?
That's a good question. It's an endless sort of thing. I'm always working on it. We're always changing it. You know, it starts early. I start building some of the props and designing those early on just because the lead time to get them done is so long. And then as we get closer, you know, we start refining what songs we'll play. Then that starts taking, you know, refining the video to go with that. It's sort of an evolving thing. You know, so the first night of any tour is kind of sketchy.
How was it on this one?
It was pretty good. I mean, it was pretty fine, but we had a lot of moving parts. I mean, it's all dialed in now, obviously, but the first couple shows, it's, you know, for good or for bad, sometimes it drives me crazy, but it's almost like you're putting on, like, a Broadway show. There's so much things rolling on, rolling off, moving around that it's chaos backstage. I mean, you try to hide all that from the audience, obviously.
How much of a crew do you have with you outside, just the band members on stage that are performing with you?
There's a lot of people. I'm not sure how many, actually. I haven't counted them, but there's a lot. I'm not even sure who everyone is sometimes.
So do you start out with sketches and then you work from there? Or
yeah, I'll sketch out you know, what I want or some certain ideas and just try to figure out what's feasible. Mostly it's what's feasible, because sometimes even though the venues seem like they're really big,
right?
Sometimes they're not. Like even today we can't use stuff because it's, even, you know, it's not big enough.
Yeah, the stage isn't the right fit.
Or sometimes just the ramps to get things on stage aren't big enough, so stuff sits in the truck. So it's an endless process.
Let's say I was watching the trucks pull up today. It seems like just with your name on the back as they're pulling in back, you know, there's a lot of stuff in there.
There's
for you
a
guys.
Lot of stuff, yeah. I mean, it pretty much fills up. I mean, every song, my thought process was for every song to have some sort of special thing that takes place, mm-hmm. you know, in each song. So everything, so it doesn't just seem like, and there's nothing wrong with this, but a band playing one song after another, after another, after another. I wanted to kind of unfold with a little more drama than that.
I was watching the earlier today. They were doing the sound check, and they were doing American Witch, and it just did the visuals for that one. And I was watching there was like an alien shooting lasers at one point on there. And
yeah, I don't know why they were playing that. We don't even play that song, but I think it's the only song they know. Truthfully, the crew always checks with that. Yeah, I don't know what was up there, but there's a lot of anime. I had, you know, there's a lot of animation we have that was done specifically for the show. And yeah, no, it all works really well now.
All the pieces moving together. Venomous Rat Regeneration Vendor, a hell of a title, a little bit of a tongue twister. Brand new album out now. I was reading somewhere that initially, even though it didn't end up this way, you kind of started as a concept record.
I mean, it kind of finished that way too. I mean, I had an idea in mind for the whole thing. I just didn't tell anybody because I figured there was no need. But yeah, no, I kind of came up with a storyline in my mind that I wanted everything to connect through, mm-hmm. in case someday I wanted to do something else with it, which I might, you know.
So there's still a possibility of that story being told and unfolding?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. But usually what happens is it's unrealistic for me to ever want to go back and revisit something, because it's usually about, well, what's next, rather than going back and like, oh, let's revisit that and turn it into something else. But who knows?
So now on this record, your second single, We're an American Band, a cover tune, you've done several in your career. What for you makes you just pick a particular song, go with that? I mean, you've had Boogeyman, Brick House, and this one in particular.
Yeah, I mean, I really haven't done very many. I mean, I've only recorded 3 cover songs in the span of almost 30 years. We would never play cover songs randomly. I never put any on a real record. I mean, mm-hmm. the other ones were sort of like on, you know,
yeah,
throwaway soundtracks or something. But well, I don't know. We were just looking for another song. I mean, because now records have become, unfortunately, sort of less meaningful,
mm-hmm.
you know, because I think that, you know, people don't buy albums so much. They just sort of download the one song they like more so, and it's kind of a drag. So the concept of the whole thing is
lost
and diminished. So I thought, well, it's all about the live show. Everything's about the live show now. So I thought, well, a cover song would be a good way to get another song instantly recognizable mm-hmm. to the crowd, rather than the thought that, oh, you're going to keep playing new songs and working them, because it's just that system doesn't really exist anymore. So with that in mind, I thought, well, obviously, if we're going to do a cover, we have to do something that everybody knows, even though I'm sure some of the younger fans don't know it.
Right.
But, you know, we tried to pick something fairly obvious that we could relate to and would be fun to play, and something ridiculous that we would never write.
And it's a hell of a tune. You guys did a really great cover for it. When I was listening to the record, I'd seen it there, but I didn't go to it. I was like, I'm going to listen front to back and then just get to it and see how it works into the process.
Yeah, I mean, truthfully, everybody, even the producer, thought it was a stupid idea, but when we were done, he was like, yep, it worked.
This definitely works for us. So with this record, you're moving forward now. You're going to be touring for quite some time. I was reading the other day you're going to do a first ever live DVD for yourself. Is that something you've been working on for a long time, or is it just kind of something recently you're like, yeah, we need to do it?
It's always seemed like a huge nuisance, truthfully.
Because you had the live record.
Made a live record, and that took long enough. I mean, that took a million years to do. And a live DVD, for some reason to me, always seems like a nuisance, because I never want to, after the show's done, I don't care.
Yeah, you're
done.
I never
want to relive it. I mean, certain members of the band, certain one in particular, films every show and wants to watch it immediately after the show. And it aggravates the f*** out of me. Who gives a shit? The show is over. I don't care. I never want to hear about it again. I never want to see it again. Like, I never watch anything, a TV show I've ever been on, nothing. I don't care. Once it's done, it's done. But I figured at least once we should film it, because we've had so many big, crazy stage shows over the last many, many years, and we never filmed anything with White Zombie back then. Yeah, you know, I mean, there's little clips of
here and there,
that are, you know, the Brazilian television or something were filmed. So, I mean, we haven't done it yet. We're going to do it in Texas when we get to Texas, but who knows? I may change my mind at the last minute.
Not going to happen.
Yeah.
So
it guarantees you that the worst show you ever play will be the night that you go film it.
The one you actually do. Now, when you did the live record, was that over the course of several shows, or was that just one shot?
No, that was just one night in Detroit we did. Detroit's always fun, so we thought, oh, that'd be a good place to record.
It came out right. I mean, it's a great little record.
I never really listened back to it. I already heard it. Did it once.
Don't care to relive it.
Not really, no.
Well, let's talk about your movies real quick. Obviously, Lords of Salem just came out recently. I know you're working on a, is it the Broad Street Bullies?
Broad Street Bullies, yeah. Well, I'm working on, that's in the early stages.
Okay.
Lords of Salem comes out in September on DVD. And then in October, I'm doing this thing called The Great American Nightmare, which is this two-week Halloween thing in California with bands and haunted mazes and car shows and wrestling and all this stuff. And then I know we're headed to South America and stuff. We have a lot of touring to do, but somewhere along the lines, and I'm in the early stages of casting and putting the financing together for Broad Street Bullies, which is, you know, the true life story of the Philadelphia Flyers in 1974 winning the Stanley Cup, which sounds like a boring story if you don't like hockey, but it's a crazy story, and it's definitely a movie for non-sports fans also.
Well, now for you, obviously, you've done horror and what have you in sci-fi pretty much up until now. Why the change now for you? Is something different for you?
Wanted to do different stuff. I mean, I never wanted to do just one type of movie, and even within what I was doing, I would, you know, want to make it different. Like, even with House of a Thousand Corpses, with the second one, I didn't want to make House of a Thousand Corpses Part 2. I had no interest in that, so I decided to just make a totally different movie. But it's so hard to make movie. I mean, it's so hard to get the financing and the money, because it just takes so many millions of dollars even to make a cheap movie, that I never want to turn anything down, because, you know, the opportunities are hard to come by. So I've just done what I could at the moment, but the next bunch of projects lined up, none of them are horror projects.
Oh, that's cool. So for you, do you get mostly a phone call for stuff, or are you just kind of, hey, you know, you're thinking about it and this is what you want to do?
It comes and goes different ways. I mean, like, you take all these endless meetings that are useless. Like, when I did the Halloween films, you know, I was so sick of taking meetings with people, and I was like, this is literally the last meeting I'm taking. I can't stand talking to anyone. And I went in, met with, you know, Bob Weinstein from Dimension, and that's how that happened. You know, sometimes things materialize into something. And like Broad Street Bullies, this guy who I didn't even know, he had approached the Flyers and purchased the rights to their story and came to me, not knowing if I was a hockey fan or if I cared, because he just thought the sensibility of what I had done in the other films would fit a period film about hockey. And, you know, then he found out, yeah, I was a big hockey fan, especially during that time period as a kid. And It just
worked out.
Whatever movie you think you're going to do is never the movie you do it. Something weird thing always comes out of somewhere else. Always.
Interesting. Well, I look forward to seeing that when you finally do it and hearing about whatever else is coming down the pike for you, because I know you got, like you said, you got a few more things, but I'm guessing you can't say too much on it just yet.
Yeah, no, I mean, there's other things I probably forgot about, but I'm just trying to get through today.
There you go, man. Well, congratulations on all the success, man, and looking forward to that live DVD if you end up doing it and not
change
your mind.
We'll see. I might change my mind.
Last second. Rob Zombie, thank you so much, brother.
Sure.